Hey, what's going on YouTube? In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can combine multiple gradients in a single object. So a few months ago, I made a different video on the same subject and I showed you how you can do this with using masks and a few other techniques. So if you want to go back and check that one out first, feel free. However, I've recently come up with a much quicker way and easier way of doing this, so I thought I'd share that with you today. So to get started, we're going to come over here to the left hand side toolbar menu and select one of the shape tools here. For this tutorial, I'm going to go with an ellipse, but you can choose any shape you like. It will work with any of those. So once you've selected your shape, just simply drag it out on your canvas. If you hold down the shift key, that will hold your constraints and proportions perfectly. And once you're happy with that, we can continue with adding our first gradient. And to do that, we're going to go back over to the left-hand side toolbar and select that fill tool right there. So once we've selected our fill tool, we just got to decide which direction we want our gradient to go just by simply placing your mouse cursor anywhere and dragging down. If for any reason you're not happy with how you place that, you can simply rotate it just by dragging any of these handles on the end just into a different direction. So you can see we've got this grey one down here and this white one up here. We can simply change the colours of these over here in the colour wheel to anything you prefer. Or alternatively, we can come up to the top bar menu up here and we can do it in here also. The benefits to doing it over here is we can add additional colours in there if we want by tapping anywhere on this line right there. And you can put in as many of these as you like just simply by double tapping. And then we can just come in and change the color of this, maybe make that a bit lighter. And this one here, we'll give that a different color. And just change all these to something you're more happy with. Just like that. So this doesn't look great at all. It's just going to be a quick example. I hope you choose better colors than I have. But also in here, we have this option here where we can change the type of gradient that we've got here. Just by going through these settings, or you can keep that as it was on linear. And we can also change the opacity on any of these points by selecting them, and you can just drag that opacity down. So you could have that fade into a zero opacity so you can see through it if you wanted to, but I'll leave it as it was. And we can also reverse the gradient right there, so it'll select the colors on that side and bring it over here. So once you're happy with your color choice, which I'm not really, but it will do just to quickly demonstrate, we can move on. So we're going to come off this shape here just for a moment. And what we need to do next is we've got to make a copy of this circle or any shape that you guys are using. So to do that, we're just going to select it. We'll hit that Command C and Command V on the Mac. And I think that's Control C and Control V on a Windows computer. And you can see we've got a copy over here now. So I'm just going to resize that, holding down that shift key to keep it perfectly rounded like we did before. And what I'm going to do now is I want to drag this one inside of the one underneath. So we use this one here as a mask. And what that will allow us to do is keep this circle inside of this one. So I'll quickly demonstrate that just by dragging this down. We've got this big blue bar there and we want to shrink that over to the right a little bit. So if we drag it over, you'll see that eventually it will get a bit smaller. Just like that, and when it gets to that point, you just let go, and now it is inside of this circle here. So no matter where we move this around, it's masked inside of the circle on top of it. So now we've done that, we can simply change the colors on this gradient by coming back over to the fill tool, and we can come in and edit this. So we'll come back up here, and if you've got too many colors in here, you can select it and you can just delete some of these colors. So I'm going to leave maybe just two in this one, and then we'll do another one in a minute. So let's change the colors on here. Maybe that there. And the yellow down there, perhaps. And like I said before, we can move this around if you want to any direction. If you want to add more colors, you can also do that here by double tapping anywhere on this line. If you want to delete them, just select it and delete it. So next we are going to do the exact same thing that we just did. We're going to now make a copy of this circle. So Command or Control C again, and Command and Control V again, Windows or Mac. And we're just going to now move this into place to wherever you want. You can obviously make this a lot bigger or smaller. You can do anything you like with that. You can add as many of these in here as you like just to make a better effect and change all the colors. So once again, we're going to change the fill colors on here for the gradient. to something a bit different to what we've already got. Maybe that blue, a bit darker. And we'll go for maybe a bit of green down this end. So as stated before, we can just move these around if you want to. It's entirely up to you what you want to do with your colors and which direction you want it to go. So if I grab that move tool, I can just move this around freely inside and make it bigger or smaller. I think I'll make that a little bit bigger. And this now is where we are going to combine all this together into one gradient. And to do that, we're just going to simply come onto one of these circles. We'll start off with this big green one. And we're going to come down to the effects, which is right down there at the bottom, the layer effects. I'm going to tap on that. And we're going to select this Gaussian blur or Gaussian blur, however you like to pronounce that. So once we tick that, we've got this radius bar right there. And by default, this will only go up to 100, as you can see. But we can change that manually just by double tapping and putting in our own number. So if we bring this up to 100, you can see what's going on here. It starts to soften on the edges, making it easier to blend into what is behind it. I don't really think 100 is enough on this, so maybe we could double up on that and put 200 or any number that you want to do. It's trial and error. Just see what you can get out of this. And to me, that looks better already. So I'm going to come off that one and we're going to do the exact same thing on the circle underneath. Back to the effects, Gaussian or Gaussian blur. Stick 200 on that one as well. And it's kind of doing the same thing that we've already done. So as we have a little look at it now, you can see they've all kind of blended in, but the color choice isn't amazing. So this is non-destructive. We can always come back in here and change everything. We can always move things around to wherever you want them. So we can still come and change the colors again by grabbing that fill tool and deciding to go with something that may look better with those colors. So it's a case of having a little play around and see what you can find here to blend these nicer. That looks better already. And then we could possibly change this one in the background as well. And don't forget that we can always change the direction of the fill also, or the gradient. And I think we'll change that color there. And it's just a case of you guys playing around with this and seeing what it is that you can achieve and the kind of look that you are going for. So I'm going to leave that like that and back down here, and then we can obviously move this around again like I stated. So you see we've got all these different colors all combined now, and I'm going to change that one as well just to give that a little bit more, maybe darker than we had, just so you can see there is more color in here. And perhaps just leave that somewhere like that. I'm not a fan of this color down there, but this is just a quick demonstration. You can obviously come in and change this if you want to, and we can just drag it out so it fades a little bit better if you like. So I'm just going to leave it like that just for the moment. But what I want to quickly demonstrate is that this obviously is not your final design. We can edit this as much as you like. We can even delete them if you're not happy with it. Turn it on and off. Add as many of these as you want, all different shapes, whatever you want to do. And we can always come back. And if you think that is too soft, we can change these numbers here. So we can make it harder. Just go back to 100, or we can just go for 150. And just play around with the settings and see what it is that you like to do and what works for you. And as you can see, once we close it, we've got this one single object, and we can just resize that and move that around as you like. You can go straight in and put your effects on as you usually would. So if we're putting out a shadow on here, let's put 15 by 15. And everything will work as it would, as though you was working on a single object. So I hope you liked this video and you guys chose some better colors than me, because this really does not look good. But like I said, we can always go back at any point and we can change all the perimeters, all the colors, and just move things around just to make them look a little bit better. So simply just by moving things slightly, they could already look better anyway without changing any colors. It's all down to what you can do as an artist. Please hit that like button, as that really helps out with the YouTube algorithm and helps people see my video. And of course, if you don't mind, please subscribe and check out any future videos that I've got. But for now, enjoy the rest of your day and I will see you in the next video.